My name is Waldemar Grabski. I work at the Institute of Computer Science, Warsaw University of Technology. I will talk about the eco-mobility project and empty vehicle management. What can you see in the picture? There is a man who may have difficulties with going down the stairs. More and more people have problems with their mobility, and they can't use traditional means of transport. Therefore, our thinking about transport has to change. Vehicles should be designed in such a way that less mobile people can access and use them. This type of thinking underlines the eco-mobility project. The project was carried out at Warsaw University of Technology and co-financed by European Regional Development Fund. The chairman of the project was Professor Włodzimierz Choromański. The name of the project, the eco-mobility, refers to an environmental friendly transportation system and resources, especially in metropolitan areas. The system takes into account the needs of people with disabilities. The project was divided into five tasks. EcoCar is designated for people with both full and in part mobility. Disabled people can drive the car from their wheelchair. Exoskeleton enables people with lower limb disabilities to stand upright, walk, and even climb the stairs. Two types of wheelchairs were designed, an electric wheelchair with star climbing capability and manual, the lever-operated one. Stabilizers and endoprotheses, which use innovative materials. An innovative PRT system with a linear motor, wireless energy transmission to the podcar, and energy recuperation was designed. As a part of the project, a scaled-down working model of the simple truck and podcar was made and tested. The full-scale podcar cab and its interface system were designed with disabled people in mind. The PRT network simulator Phoenix was made. This work has been carried out by a team from the Institute of Computer Science. This part of the project was my undertaking, and I became the main developer of the simulator. The Phoenix simulator allows statical network analysis, for example, total track length, average distance between stations, and maximum walking distance, which is shown in the picture. Phoenix enables conductive massive experiments in parallel, 50 and more. It also enables automatization of the simulation process by generating experiments and managing them. The simulation results are saved in global database. What are the PRT network simulation objectives? It's algorithm verifications. There are two types of algorithms: coordination, for example, keeping the track up, and management algorithm, especially empty vehicle management. Another objective is to check network ridership and network capacity. The question on influence the network structure and parameters on its quality and performance. The empty vehicle management algorithm has four tasks. Each task has its own set of parameters. The tasks are calling, delivering vehicles for waiting passenger, withdrawing, moving unnecessary vehicles to capacitors, expelling, making room for approaching vehicles when the station is full, and balancing, relocation of vehicles for better accessibility. Balancing and expelling were subject of detailed research. In this slide, you can see our benchmark model city. An example of the horizon is shown for the station J. The station controller at J has precise information about the status of four neighboring stations only. We have performed experiments for a number of various horizon values. My algorithms work well with an average horizon, which means that it's well suited for distributed implementation. To compare the effectiveness of my algorithm with other ones, we used the grid benchmark known in the subject literature. We expected my algorithm to be suboptimal because the controller's knowledge is limited by the horizon. The experiments demonstrated that my algorithm is better than nearest neighbors, better than surplus deficit for raw smaller than 0.3, and worse than sampling and voting. And case study. Rzeszów, a biggest city in southeastern Poland, was used as a case study. Rzeszów has a dense built-up old town area and town center ring road. We plan a three-layer transportation system for the central part of Rzeszów. A higher layer, the red cycle, represents a monorail ring. A middle layer, blue lines, represents PRT highways. And a lower layer, cross-hatching, represents slower PRT. The transportation demand was based on a statistical population analysis. For the northern half of the town center, there were 352 requests per hour, which was calculated for PRT as 140 groups per hour, average 2.5 persons in a group. For the monorail calculations, it was assumed that a train should pass every 10 minutes. So there were 6 trains needed. The maximum ridership was calculated as 2,251 passengers per hour. It was over 3 times greater than estimated requests. In this slide, the PRT network for the northern part is shown. There are PRT highways, PRT commuter network, 22 ordinary PRT stations, and 6 monorail PRT transfer stations. The total demand is 148 groups per hour, that is close to estimated value. The result of the PRT simulations are presented in the table. The first experiment showed that the network worked efficiently. It was for the input of 148 groups per hour and 35 vehicles. The safety margin for the safety margin was sufficient. It should be at least 2. In the second experiment, the input was doubled, that resulted in average queues 4 times longer and a very low safety margin. It means that the network dangerously close to destruction. In the third experiment, we checked how the network would operate with the number of vehicles enlarged to 45. It resulted in safety margin higher than previously, but still too low. The length were cut by half. It was done at a cost of more empty trips. So the system worked at acceptable level of efficiency. In our analysis, we used calculations for monorail and simulations for PRT. It showed that 35 vehicles were enough to operate efficiently PRT network for northern part of Rzeszów center. It has proved that the proposed transportation system for central part of Rzeszów is possible and reasonable. In our future research, we plan to work on the distributed simulation algorithm and to use a farm environment, maybe cloud, to perform massive simulations. The cooperation between PRT and other means of transport is another area that needs to be researched. We are also interested in dual mode vehicles and creating a simulator and management algorithm for them. Thank you for your attention.